More problems have been exposed at a New Mexico facility housing immigrants. A new report finds inhumane and unsanitary conditions. It has some calling for an immediate closure of the facility. News 13's George Gonzalez breaks down the findings of that report.
A moldy sink that doesn't work, a toilet clogged with human waste, a detainee filling a cup of water from a mop sink, and guards unable to adequately monitor and supervise detainees because of blind spots and staffing issues. Those problems and more revealed in a 19-page report by the Department of Homeland Security Inspector General following an unannounced inspection last month at the Torrance County Detention Facility in Estancia.
We hear from detained people in this facility day in and day out, reporting, you know, the weather in the showers being contaminated to where they're getting rashes breaking out.
The facility is being used by ICE to house migrants while their immigration cases are being reviewed. At the time of the inspection, 176 men were being held there.
We and other legal service providers have been raising concerns about these issues for many months, in fact, years at this point.
Aside from the health issues, the report found only 54% of the required amount of staff was employed at the time of the inspection.
They're not able to get the attention of guards because the understaffing issues at Torrance are so severe.
Core Civic, who owns and operates the jail along with ICE, dispute the findings. They accuse the OIG of misrepresenting evidence, saying that the photos of the clogged sinks and toilets were taken in vacant housing units and wet floors were actually in the process of being cleaned by detainees. They go as far as to say inspectors staged a photo of the detainee drinking out of the mop sink.
Regardless of the authority that, you know, agencies like ICE might have to detain people, there is no justification for holding them in such degrading and inhumane conditions.
A federal watchdog says based on the findings, everyone being held at the Torrance County facility should be immediately transferred elsewhere. The ACLU goes a step further, calling for the release of all detainees.
They are experiencing conditions that go to fundamental questions of dignity and safety.
George Gonzalez, KRQE News 13.
Core Civic receives about $2 million a month from the government to operate that Torrance County facility, and this is not the first time the facility has had trouble. 2 years ago, detainees were engaged in a hunger strike when guards pepper sprayed them and blocked the exits. Detainees later sued Core Civic as well as Torrance County.